This is the Madison College Writing Center's 2-Minute Tutors. I'm Kate Stover.
I'm Suzanne Triber, and today we are going to answer the question, where do periods and commas go when you use quotation marks?
For about the next 2 minutes, we'll focus on the most common challenges writers have.
It actually depends on how the writer is using quotation marks.
That's right. Let's talk about writing dialogue and using sources. Let's look at an example of each of those, Suzanne.
Sure. Look at this sentence. With dialogue, we put periods and commas inside of the quotation marks, like this.
That's right. Avoid putting commas incorrectly outside of the quotation mark, as you'll see here in the second sentence.
Another mistake to avoid is putting the period outside the quotation marks as well.
Now, let's talk about using quotation marks when writing an academic paper.
Okay, if you quote a source, you need to tell the reader where the quote came from. That information is called an in-text citation.
In the first example, you see the writer starts with a quote, then includes the source information in parentheses, then adds the period, right here.
Yes, the period goes after the source, not after the quote.
Just remember, the source is not part of the quote, but it is part of the sentence, and that's why the period goes at the end.
That's a great way to remember it, Kate.
Thanks.
Now, sometimes the writer includes the name of the source in the sentence.
If they do that, then they don't have to use parentheses.
Correct. But a writer does have to put the comma inside the quotation marks, as you see here.
Yes, there's another situation. The source comes before the quote.
That means the comma comes before the quote as well. And the period goes inside the quotation marks, like you see here.
It's time to practice. Pause this video and use what you've learned to work on these sentences.
Both of these sentences have problems. Do you want to take the first one, Kate?
Sure. Let's start by asking, is this dialogue or a quote from a source? It looks like dialogue, so we'll move the comma inside the quotation marks and the period goes at the end of the sentence.
Perfect. Now the second sentence has a quote from a source. The problem here is that there is an extra period. The only place you need a period is at the very end, right here. So delete this one.
Time to recap. First, decide how you are using the quotation marks.
Is it for dialogue? If so, periods and commas go inside quotation marks.
If it's for identifying a source, the period goes at the end of the sentence.
And remember, only one period per sentence.
Need more information about quotations? Why not talk to a tutor at your nearest writing center? We'd be delighted to help. Well, Suzanne, it looks like our work here is done.
Right on, Kate.
Right on, Suzanne, and thank you all for joining us.